Hi. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to When This Ever Plays, The Binding of Undertale. This is 98, I think. So close to the big 100. In preparation for that, I was taking a look through some of my other videos, and I discovered that, much to my own personal horror, the way I have been rendering my videos for the past several months is actually really, really shitty. The quality is awful, it gets framey, it's super gross. So I did a bunch of research and found a solution. I believe this particular video is a test, okay? I'm gonna be doing two different things. One, I'm gonna be recording in 1080p instead of 720p. And two, when I actually render it into a format that YouTube can use, I'm gonna be using a different program than one I usually do with different settings. So things might seem a bit different, and hopefully they will be different and better. Hopefully. That's the plan. So today, okay. Actually, no. Nah, I want someone else. It's been a long time since I played as, like, Alphys, I think. Mad Dummy, obviously. Muffet's been a while. Metaton? You know what? Sure, it's been quite a while since I played as the hot robot that everyone loves. I think it might have been... It's either been longer for Alphys or Metaton. I'm uncertain which. But, yeah, this'll do. So, let's see. I'll just keep this then. So in case you're wondering about anything about, you know, the finale, what I'm going to go ahead and call the series finale, I've already got some pretty neat plans in order, like, floating around in my mind for what I'm going to do for it, but I'm not going to spoil anything, not yet. The only thing that I'm willing to spoil is that it involves the word episode in great big quotation marks. That's it. That's the only thing. It's episode, quote-unquote. It's quote-unquote episode. And then 100. That's it. That's all it is. Functionally a series finale, but, you know, it's whatever it is. I think it's gonna be awesome, alright? I have some cool plans. I'm gonna do some neat stuff. It's gonna be a great time. So, in the meantime, though, we still play in this. We're still playing this game as we will. What was that? Charm Tears, I think? Pretty sure that one's Charm Tears. No, it's Mom's Contact. Sorry. Freezing Tears. That's correct. And by correct, I mean more accurate. Okay, let's see. This is Empress. That's the one I'm probably going to end up taking with me. Second secret room, perchance? Hey, look at that. And also glitter bombs. Doing its thing. Ooh. Alright, I'm interested. I'm just gonna... There we go. Disable those gosh darn red fires real quick. Because those things do little more than annoy me. Dude! Look at that! Look at that start. Damn. That's awesome. That is actually just straight up fantastic. I mean, functionally, Mom's Contacts, and Cricket's Head. Jeez. It's great. I love it. Look at that. Look at how quickly Ragman just melts with this build that I've got going already. I mean, to be fair, I still firmly believe that Metaton is by far the most powerful of all the characters in this mod, but that aside, just because Metaton is probably the most OP in the early game, that doesn't mean that, you know, the items you get, the RNG that you're faced with, doesn't play a significant role in how things go. It is an RNG-based game, after all. Oh my god. It has been such a strange day. This is day one of 2 days off in a row from work since I got the schedule modification I've been asking for, where I went from basically like 35 to 40 hours a week down to pretty much 28 every single time. You know what? I'll take this. Because there's probably going to be a Bible in here. There isn't! I'm surprised. Maybe these just already spawned. Well, I'll take this then. I guess we will never see the Bible then. Nah, but because I have the really. Because I have that modified schedule, I have 2 days off in a row right now. Like, I had 2 days on, 2 days off, and then I'll have 2 days on, then a day off, and then two on, and then two off, and then one on, and then two off, and then one on, something like that. I haven't, like, super crazy mega thoroughly studied my schedule, even though I probably should have by now. Yeah, sure. Wow. Lovely. But, yeah, but you know, since I have these days off, I figured, like, well, I guess I can stay up a little bit later tonight. This was last night's the thought process going through my head. I can stay up a little bit later. I can, I don't know, take some time to relax a little bit. I didn't record any videos yesterday for that reason. Because I spent all of the day when I wasn't at work just chilling. What does it look like? Oh my god. With the mom's box effect, this is ridiculous. Look at how high the shot height is. Jesus Christ. I mean, I don't think I really want that, but holy crap. God damn, that's something else. Right there, Jesus. You know, Blind Rage here would actually be pretty good with the mom's box. It really would be. I mean, every time I take damage, I would get, like, crazy mega and insane iframes. But I think I'm gonna stick with no for now. Yeah, that's right. You froze. You froze! Oh, hello. I'm gonna stick with no for a while until I find a trinket that's, like, absolutely phenomenal. Which, I'm sure I probably will. Somewhere along the way. Also, there's the Bible. Hello. I knew I'd see ya. Okay, so we take Rotten Baby because that's actually pretty good. And we skedaddle. So, you know, as I was saying, I was thinking I'd stay up late last night, which I did. I'm just like, oh, I guess I'll stay up a little late. I don't know, go to bed at like 1:30, 2 o'clock, something like that. Little, maybe an hour later than normal because I have to make videos tomorrow and I have to get some other stuff done. So I really don't want to completely wreck my sleep schedule, right? So, you know, I'm awake at 2 o'clock. I'm just like, okay, time for bed. I'll set a video to render, set some stuff to upload, go to sleep, etc. Really? And, so at that point, I'm just kind of like, well, I could stay up a little bit later and it really wouldn't cause any harm. So I'm just like, what if I set up my Wii U gamepad next to my bed? And then I grab my controller, my GameCube controller, which has a 10-foot cord. And what if I just, like, play Smash until I fall asleep on the Wii U gamepad, right? So I did that. I played Smash until I fell asleep at like 7 a.m. Ha 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 ha. Regret. I got maybe like 4.5 hours of sleep, I think, something like that. I mean, I'm not really particularly annoyed. I'm just kind of, my head hurts. And I feel like, and I know for a fact, that I hecked up pretty hard, yo. Tower card. You'd be surprised how little I care. I'm gonna go back and make sure these things detonate, though. Oh, I see how it is. Well, at the very least, that does work with, nice. Does work with glitter bombs, so that's cool. Yeah, that doesn't really change anything. Having mom's box with hookworm functionally. So yeah, I'm running on really low sleep right now. Probably due at least in part to the fact that I'm just like, I guess I'll stay up tonight, why not? And also because I drank way too much coffee yesterday. Just trying to make sure I didn't fall asleep at work, because the day before I legitimately almost, like, nodded off at the register. It was really slow, nothing was happening, there was no one there, and my eyes closed and I might have drifted a little bit. I don't want that. So, yeah, so in an effort to stay awake, I'm just like, I'll drink some coffee, maybe a little bit extra. A little bit more than I normally would. I learned, very definitively that I think lattes are disgusting and I don't like them. Ooh, nice. And I would much rather have just, like, legitimately, I would rather... This might come as a surprise to you guys, given what you know of my personality, but believe it or not, I would actually prefer to drink a cup of black coffee over like a latte, like a traditional latte. Well, that's restock. I wonder if I can actually use it, though, is the thing. Can I actually put that to good use? Well, if I find some money. But, yeah. So I'm running on low sleep. And then it came time, like, I woke up and I'm just like, okay, I guess I should probably eat something. What do I want to eat? And my brain was instantly, I kid you not, the exact moment that I realized I was hungry, my brain was just like, Taco Bell. Taco Bell, you gotta go to Taco Bell. You gotta get a quesalupa. Or two, get two of them. And I'm just like, brain, please, why? I don't want to do that. It'll cost me $150 just to get there, because the bus, and I don't want to walk 20 minutes to go to a Taco Bell. And then I ended up taking the bus to Taco Bell and got some quesalupas. Grabbed a few for my roommate as well, because, you know, he always, almost pretty much every time we go to Taco Bell or something like that, he'll pay for my way, so I figured, you know what? I may not have as much money as he does at my disposal, but I can still try and pay it back a little bit, right? And besides, it makes me feel good, bringing him something like that. Doing the little things that make people have a better day. I enjoy it. I really do. So, yeah, I got some Taco Bell. My belly is just full of quesalupa right now. Quesalupa and grape soda, because apparently there was some grape soda sitting in our fridge here, and no one told me not to take any. So, yeah. Now I'm just kind of chugging along, making sure I accomplish things for the day, get videos done and such, because that is still an active goal of mine. Make videos. Okay. You gonna give me cancer trinket, maybe? That ain't cancer. I'm disappointed. Fine, whatever. We keep going. So yeah, and then I'm just kind of sitting around for a while watching some videos, trying to, well, like, while eating, and I'm just like, I should really actually be recording. And then, you know, 3 hours later, I'm just like, wait a minute, I still haven't recorded anything today. Let me just fix that, so now I'm making videos. Which is, yeah, cool. So, my particular plan, by the way, for episode, quote-unquote, 100, is to record 98 and 99 today, and then tomorrow, take care of all the episode 100 stuff. There's going to be a little bit of prep work that I need to do for it, but not too much. It's not going to be anything spectacular, the series finale. It really won't be anything as, like super crazy, mega amazing. It's just going to be unique and special, I think. I'll talk more about it tomorrow. Tomorrow? I'll talk more about it on the actual day of the finale. The day that I record the finale, anyway. Discuss things a little bit more about, like, the mod, the impact it's had, how I feel about it now, etc. You know, just basic thoughts that have to do with a thing that I've been playing for a while. Not a review or anything, just a perception sort of thing. Okay. Thanks. Cool. You know, I could actually reasonably do that sacrifice room thing right there. Really? Oh, that was Mr. Mega. That wasn't Mr. Boom. I completely and totally just misjudged. Oops. So yeah, that's where things are currently. I mean, far as you're concerned, it's just gonna be more days of vidges. That ain't gonna stop. Yeah, okay, to be honest, that was completely inevitable given what just happened there. What are you? Okay. So, yeah. Mostly I'm just like kind of sort of facing the ordeal of trying to juggle a bunch of different series. Cuz you know, I started Stardew Rogue. Oh my god. Those names are so similar, I can't help it. They both start with the word star. I started Stardew Valley. I still have Starward Rogue going, I still have Borderlands going, I still have this going, although, as you're well aware by now, this is going to be changing soon. But that doesn't mean it's going anywhere, that just means it's going to be different. And there's... I've heard tell of a game called, Enter the Gungeon, I think, which I don't know anything about it, but I've been told by a viewer that it's something that would probably be right up my alley, so it's definitely a game I'll look into if someone thinks I'd like it. You know, same thing as Stardew Valley. It's not that different of a concept. I like knowing what you guys have to say. So, I guess there is technically a possibility that I will be starting a fifth series. And I don't know how to feel about that. I mean, it's... I actually have the time to devote to five different series. It's just a matter of will I have the energy for it. Because I'm still earning money, I'm going to be able to pay my rent every month. I'm not going to have any trouble with that, which is the nature of having a job. And that's and given how things turned out with that, I'm still going to have a lot of extra time. And by extra time, I mean time that I can devote specifically to this channel. So I have the time for five series at once. It really just comes down to, can I survive that? Short answer, yeah. Long answer, probably, yeah, I think so. But, like, actual legit answer? Sure. Sure. I'm gonna say sure on that front. Can't say for certain. Black candle, you say? Thank you. Hey, look, it's the Bible again. Thanks. I'm gonna guess the boss is in this direction. I'd be willing to bet, Enter the Gungeon does kind of sound like a Nuclear Throne sort of game. Nuclear Throne, McShooty sort of, probably some RNG elements, I don't know. It really sounds like that kind of thing, though. I mean, if Nuclear Throne and Tower of Guns are any indication of what, a shooty indie game looks like, and feels like, and sounds like... Oh, you know what I just realized? These Mr. Mega Bombs are gonna destroy everything. Sure. I'll start taking pills. See what I care. Tears down. Tears down, tears up. Look at that! Okay. Can I please have the freaking cancer trinket, though? Seriously. Anyway, now is a good time, I think, to go back and look for that item room. Enter the Gungeon. Well, I know it involves guns. That's as far as my awareness of it is going to go for now. I did not realize I put down a bomb. Oops. My bad. Hello. Can I put a bomb down now? But I'm actually thinking about it. Two of diamonds, nice. Well, this is definitely a hush run, so... I might as well save this for when I get down there, huh? The two of diamonds card, I mean. Might as well. This is seriously, like, a really good build, and I'm playing really well. I don't know. Things are going aight. They really are. Oh. Okay, you were still sitting there. That's weird. Hello, Boss Rush. Do you have anything I could care about? I'll take Sister Maggie! Why not? See, I kind of figured I would get the conjoined transformation, which is why I was okay with that. Not that this is an exceptionally good transformation, it's just one that I now have. And also part of my motivation for going through with Boss Rush is... Getting all the charges on Mom's box means there's a better chance I could find, a trinket that's actually worth taking and using. You know, Maggie's Faith might not actually be that bad. That's a guaranteed HP up every floor. Tempting. Who is... No one. Is that store key? Shop key? It is. Does not matter. What I wouldn't give for humming right now, seriously. Come on, give me the cancer trinket already, please. I need it. I have a strong desire. Strong desire, it is a necessity. Requirement. Must have. Please give. Give now. Come on. I know this thing can give you the cancer trinket. I've gotten it before. I know this is possible. I just need it to actually happen. That's all that I ask, game. That is all that I'm asking for right now. It's a freaking cancer trinket. God damn it. Black lipstick is cool, but not good enough. I mean, the black lipstick would actually be pretty good right now. Don't get me wrong. Please. Please. Monstro, are you gonna help me towards this end? Is my range actually good enough to hit those things over there? I don't even know. Come on. Furlurbagurd. Give me the cancer trinket. Please? Oh. God damn it. Well, 404 would be fun. I'll grant you that. It would be fun. I don't think I need the Bible, thank you very much. Well, that was silly. I guess I just did boss rush for the conjoined transformation. I mean, I'm down. Ain't gonna hurt anything. Really would have liked to replace no with something better, or at least more useful, but given how this is going, I really don't think I need anything more than, like, the only trinket that would actually be good right now. Okay, I can't say the only one that would be good. There are two trinkets that would actually be really good right now. And both of them are pretty much just directly stat ups. There's the cancer trinket, and there's curved horn. Those are the only trinkets I can think of that I would really want right now. With mom's box, of course. Gotta add that qualifier. Safety scissors. Good. Sort of. I don't care, but it's alright. Golden horseshoe is irrelevant now. I don't actually know if I picked this up already in the save, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay. You know what I still haven't decided is whether or not after I finish up this series, if I want to keep going with this file or not. I have not made this decision yet. I feel like I probably should have by now, given that I've been, you know, touting the fact that it's coming, like the end is coming for a while. But I just haven't bothered. Like, do I want to go back to, that's the wrong button. To the file I was using for Afterbirth before this series was a thing. And, like, have to unlock all that stuff again. I could. I really could. And I feel like that might be, you know what, this would absolutely be hilarious with Mom's Box. Look at that. Do I want to, though? Yeah, sure, why not? I don't need the no trinket anymore. So yeah, I think what would be the most reasonable slash logical would be going back to the file that I was using previously, so that way I wouldn't feel like I've cheated the system or anything by playing with these objectively OP characters. That's more or less what I'm thinking right now. Ha! Nerd. Which file even was I using? I was using file 1 for the Vanilla Isaac series. That's what it was. Or Vanilla Afterbirth series at this point, I suppose. Would be a more accurate description. what it was I was up to. Capitalize. Get all this money. I mean, the money is actually kind of useful right now, because I do have restock, and I am going to go fight Hush pretty soon. So having restock means I can get a bunch of items. And with the Two of Diamonds card... Although, to be honest, to be completely realistic, I probably should have stuck with the no trinket. I'll ignore that for now. I should have stuck with no, because when I get about to doing the whole restock shenanigan thing, it would have been... There would have been a much higher likelihood that I would actually get things that I could use from the shop. But, fortunately for me, I don't care. This build is good enough without it that it doesn't matter. I don't need the guarantee of getting a bunch of passive items. Can I please have goddamn cancer, though? Ow. Right. I can't fly. I knew that. Man, ripping pieces my health. I keep hitting the map button as opposed to the bomb button. What on earth? Hello. Well, gee, hello, Head of the Keeper, plus restock. Aw, yeah. Also, now my tier's hitboxes are really big, and that makes me really happy. Nice. And keep in mind, I still have this Two of Diamonds card. I've been saving it. Or wait, no, I left it a little ways behind, but it is on this floor, and I will make sure to grab it before I leave. You know, come to think of it, I don't actually know if the door to Hush stays open after you leave the room. I feel like this is something I should probably have known already. Also, I feel like it does. But does it really? Maybe I'll go back for the Two of Diamonds card now, just in case. Because that was the whole reason I was bothering to save that, you know? Louse is good. The Louse is good. But this is just more fun. This friggin' tricolor pasta noodles. Way more fun. Look at this ridiculous shot height that I get sometimes. It's crazy. Who on earth thought that was a good idea? Well, that's just the game's programming. That's just the way some of these things work in tandem with each other. Really? This was a dead end? Really? 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 Re-he-he-he-ly. Was it the three guttural H sounds in that, or was it just two? I forgot. That's a reference to Ace Ventura, in case you're not aware. And if you're not aware of what Ace Ventura is, that's fine. It's probably for the best. It's not a bad thing, it's just one of those really interesting times in Jim Carrey's career. You know, the comedian actor guy. Comedic actor? I don't know if he's actually a comedian. But Ace Ventura were interesting movies. The first two, anyway. Ow. Ha. Wrecked. You know who else just got wrecked? I just got wrecked. Believe it or not, I don't want either of those. At all. Alright, Hush. I lost a lot of health, but I have restock and I have faith that there will be at least one soul heart in this shop. Please be at least one soul heart. There's no soul heart! Nuts. I have no idea how the conjoined transformation works with Ludovico. Okay, obviously I'm taking Capricorn. How does that work, I wonder? I'm actually not aware. Well, I'm inclined to take Epiphora just because that's less of a hazard, but at the same time, Ludovico could be really good with conjoined. I really don't know. I don't know what it does. I'll take Epiphora. Which, if in case you don't know, if you keep shooting in the same direction long enough, it slowly increases your fire rate. And by increases, I mean decreases your fire rate delay. So, yeah. There's Guppy's head. There's one of the many editions of the Bible lying around. Okay, so how do I want to handle this? I could farm for trinkets, too. Farm for trinkets, maybe? What did I get there? Punch cards. Nice. Well, I guess we take this. Because restock, so why not, right? Little battery. Does not really interest me. That definitely doesn't interest me. Curved horn! Got it! And you know what? Just for funsies. Let's see if I can't get a little extra money out of these, eh? Or a soul heart, that's fine too. Just gives me Lucky Rock. I see how it is. Well, if I ever needed money... Was there a Tinted Rock in there that I just completely missed? See, these are those weird little seams you gotta look for. Ooh, a pretty fly. Nice. Nope. I wanna hold on to Lucky Rock for now, game. I'm still working with this. I got things to do, yo. And by things to do, I mean money. Lots of money. A Joker card, really. And a Tower card. This is potentially going to represent a lot of consumables. Oh, it wasn't that many, but it was something. Which one is this? Pulse. Oh, it's, I don't know which one that is. Well, I guess I don't need Lucky Rock anymore. So then we take Curved Horn. Joker card, I'll use. Has Goat Head and Multidimensional Baby. Neither of them really interest me that much, but in the interest of maintaining Polaroid invincibility, I'll take Multidimensional Baby. Yeah, at this point, I'm not going to be getting any more deals with the devil, so there's no reason to take that. Diplopia, you say? Alright, Diplopia's interesting. Diplopia. What could I get out of that? See, I'm not sure there's anything that I could get out of it at this point. There are no more. Well, actually, that's. Let me think. Yeah, there's not really anything else I could get. There's not really anything I could get out of Diplopia, and I really don't want to leave behind Mom's box because I have literally 4 damage up from Curved Horn right now. I can't get rid of that. So I guess that's it for my shenanigans in here. Give Temmie the rest of my money. I know I could also blow up the rocks in here, but I don't care enough to bother. Okay, let's do this. This should be an interesting one. I mean, my damage is going to be crazy good. And also, I'm aware that I do have Sackhead and Head of the Keeper, so... Melt. Melt beneath my fury, Hush. I cannot see the bullets that are coming at me. That's not good. I can't see them at all. You know, it would be nice if I could actually see what I'm meant to be dodging. I can kind of see what's coming at me. It's just that with Deadeye, it makes things really difficult to discern. Also, holy shit, get completely destroyed, Hush. Jesus Christ. Never stood a chance. Sure. Use the sun card, whatever. Use the two of hearts because I have no red heart container, so it doesn't matter. How about you get your ass back up here so I can continue destroying you? Thank you. I appreciate it. I think other than Chaos Card slash Knife Shenanigans, that was objectively the fastest Hush kill I've ever done. Oh, Curved Horn, I love you, but cancer with Mom's box. I'm sorry. I have to. This is actually necessary. I want that money, but whatevs. Okay, I have to see what this looks like. It's so slow. Anyway. So I got Wheel of Fortune, which I'm taking with me. Strength, Hermit. Keep the Wheel of Fortune card. Well, I finally got cancer. And now what I need to know is, does Epiphora actually work with this? Yeah, it totally does. Why are they spewing out relatively randomly? That doesn't seem right. Unless it's an item I have that I just don't realize is what's going on. I bet this looks hilarious. No, not really. Okay, well, I guess I have a little bit more money, so back we go, get a few more items. Deck of cards. Gave me a hangman card, which means basically nothing to me. All right, I know what I'm doing with Diplopia. Oh. Oh my, look at all that. But now, what I'm up to with Diplopia is getting one of these for free. Because Spider Mod. Is there anything else in here I could actually give a crap about? I don't think there is. Yeah, not really. So we take Cancer, take Wheel of Fortune. We got our Spider Mod buddy. The only thing I need now is some more freaking health. Which I'll probably find somewhere along the way. I'd be willing to bet. God damn. I mean, this is still absolutely amazing anyway, so whatever, right? And I'm taking Wheel of Fortune just because it represents one more item on the last floor. Might as well. Yeah, there's really no reason to bother with Mom's Box anymore. I have what I think is objectively the best trinket to have with Mom's Box. So I'm not super concerned about using it anymore. I really don't need to. There's also no reason to be bothering to pick up consumables at this point. Not like I need any more. Especially bombs. In all honesty, I could have just hung back on the last floor, on the Hush floor. I don't think that really does anything. I could have just hung back. And, what am I thinking here? Spammed bombs, because I have Bomber Boy and I have Glitter Bombs. Coulda. Definitely coulda. Hey, look, more free stuff. Woo! Yeah, there's some health I needed. So that's cool. Magician card. Two of clubs, doesn't matter. Two of hearts, also doesn't matter. Death doesn't matter, question mark. Where's my Wheel of Fortune? Oh, I left it behind. I temporarily replaced it with a moon card. That's what happened. At this point, honestly, I'm just looking for two Wheel of Fortunes. Okay. I probably should have kept that magician card too, to be honest. But whatever. What difference does it actually make? None, by the way, is the answer there. No difference. Oh boy, umbilical cord, thanks. I love it. Can anyone else join me in saying that that was definitely the best use of the death card you've ever seen? Anyone else? Anyone at all? Because if that's something that you think, you really might want to reconsider your definition of the word best. No. I still need some health, though. I am in dire need of health. That's not health. That's another freaking two of clubs. I don't need it. I don't need it. I don't want it. It doesn't help me. I want something that's actually useful. Fine. I'll keep spamming that because I can. Whatever. There's batteries everywhere. I might as well. Aight. Cool. Let's beat up Metaton Neo, shall we? Try and get some Epiphora action in here. And then immediately negate it, but that's fine. Tower, Lovers, Magician. So what we do is we take the tower card in here, and we just keep those damn bombs away from me, and then we use this other tower card. Oh, hey, look at that. Oh my god. There's so much stuff. We blow that up. Use this arbitrarily. Judgment. Judgment Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, that's two items. I mean, I might as well. Judgment Wheel of Fortune. Cool. And then you have... I don't want that. Because that would ruin my Polaroid invincibility, and I kind of like having Polaroid invincibility currently. Very nice. Cool. Let's go get our free items and beat the hell out of Sans, I guess. Assuming I don't do anything stupid. Sorry, I had to sniff off to my side there because my computer is making that awful, awful noise and I thought I smelled something burning, but thankfully I didn't. It was just my imagination.
Wheel of Fortune.
Aight, that's double shot. Oh my. Oh my, that's a double shot. Oh man. Oh man. Oh boy. Holy shit, that's homing. And you know what's hilarious is that for all this trouble, I still don't have like phenomenal damage. My damage is just okay at best. It's not even that good. I mean, don't get me wrong, I know it's good. It's above average by far, but it's nothing compared to some breaking stuff I've seen before. And yet, somehow, some way, I'm having a great time. This is fantastic. Yeah, sure, Fate's Reward is fine. If only I could actually challenge Omega Flowey with this. That'd be great. I don't care about any of that. Sure. 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 Oh my god. Party streamers. That's what this reminds me of. Party streamers. For some reason, I couldn't think of it. Oh, as Epiphora increases your fire rate, it decreases your accuracy. I see. That makes sense. Look at this. Look at this. Anyway. I'm just gonna go ahead and say that's good enough for today. Hit me into the thing. I am disappointed. Well, whatevs. So that's it for today. Thanks for watching. I will see all y'all tomorrow with episode 99. There's nothing special going on there, just another regular episode. But after that, some neat stuff going on. Anywho, I'm going to give my computer a chance to cool off for a bit here. So, yeah, I'm always out. Catch the next one. Oh, and by the way, let me know what you think about this new style of video quality. So remember, I'm recording in a higher resolution, and I'm rendering the video into a format that YouTube can use using a different program with different settings. So hopefully that will bump up the quality to make it look a little more smooth, as most YouTube Let's Plays should be. Anyway, yeah, I'm out of here. See you next time, folks. Folks, Volkswagen. You're all cars now. That makes sense. Don't question it.